UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Now we'll be discussing about API points. Here in LoadRunner, basically if you've been observing, like you have been using LR underscore, think underscore, time, we were using this one. And we were using LR underscore, start underscore, transaction, right? So basically these are, in general we can call these are the API calls which are related to LoadRunner, specifically LoadRunner library file I can say. These are some generic functions. In a general word, I can say these are the functions. Right, technically, we call it as API calls, application program interface calls, or in general, we will call it as a functions. Okay. So here, what I'm saying here we'll have two types of API calls. Okay. One is LoadRunner related. The other is application related, or I can say protocol related. Okay, now this LoadRunner related are nothing but whatever the API call or whatever the function we start with LR underscore. Okay. Whose name starts with LR underscore will be called as a LoadRunner related API calls or LoadRunner related functions. Now if you look at here. Now here we have listed on some set of LoadRunner related API calls. Okay, among these API calls, so there is a start transaction and end transaction. So we know about these things. Actually, these are the two things that we have discussed as part of transactions. As part of transactions concept, we have discussed about this particular concept. Okay, and LR underscore think time, again this is something we have discussed. This we have discussed as part of the settings, as part of runtime settings. This we have discussed as part of runtime settings. I hope everyone has remembered the what is meant with think time. And LR abort and LR exit, basically these are two which will help, basically which abort the user and exit a user. Okay, say for example you are executing a script and you are saying you are executing this script. Actually this is related to a bit of the controller. When you are trying to execute this virtual user script in controller, basically these two will help. Abort means it is basically stop the entire script. Exit means a particular user will exit the current execution. Okay, and these two, if you remember, we have discussed as part of transaction in the else condition. If a transaction get fails, we understood that it is preferable to exit the user and all. So now we understood that if login transaction got failed, it means login is not successful. So in that case, there is no meaning in continuing the execution. So in that case, probably we can use LR exit. Okay, so here now, based on the scenarios, based on the requirement, you can use these two. Okay. And here today we will be understanding in depth of this LR eval string, LR save string. We already understood, but now today we will try to understand in depth of these two, and which will be very frequently used in our programming over here. Okay. These are the two things which will be used very frequently in our programming. We'll discuss this. And LR output message. Here LR output message is to print a message on the console. We have been using this also. Okay. Now let's start with this LR eval string and the save string. Okay. We'll try to understand these two. Let me take one script here. So let me say C language 3. Again, before we understood this LR eval string and save string, let's try to understand what is this LR and what is this C language here. Basically here we understood that API calls here in LoadRunner will have two types, LoadRunner related, application related. And moreover here, these are the API calls. Say if you want to use a variable, if you want to use some C variable here, you cannot directly use in the virtual user generator programming. Try to understand my statement here. What I'm saying here, say if you have a variable, if you have a C variable, yesterday we were discussing how to create a variable here. So if you have a C variable, that we cannot directly use in our program. Okay, in these API calls, basically we cannot directly use our C variables. Now see here. The other way, let me say here, variables in LoadRunner. This is very important. As I said, it is very frequently we will be using variables in LoadRunner. I can say two types. One is C related, LoadRunner related. Okay. So here C related means yesterday we were discussing this variable, right? Yesterday we were understanding how to create a variable here in C language. That is C related. LoadRunner related means, here by using API calls, basically we can capture the information into LoadRunner parameters. Okay, by using API calls, let me say by using few API calls, we can retrieve the information from the application. We can retrieve the information from the application. Information into parameters. Yep. Can you give any example for this? We already discussed one of the LoadRunner API call. In that LoadRunner API call, basically we have some parameter which talks about the number of occurrences of a string. Did you remember what is the which API call that we have understood? In one of the API call that we understood, where it basically captures the number of occurrences of a string. Did you all remember? Okay, let me ask the question in this. Now, as part of verification concept, which API call we were discussed? I'm asking about API call. Okay, fine. Okay. I think, instead of explaining this, I would have completed this one. That's correct, Devin. Yeah. However, first of all, we'll complete this topic. We'll complete this particular topic. Then we'll get into the details of this. Okay. So here I said API calls are two types. Okay, LoadRunner related, application related. These are the some LoadRunner related API calls. Okay. and application related API calls, we'll first of all understand that, and then we'll we'll discuss the in detail about this load and related API calls. Okay. Now here we understood application load and related. Say let me say application related protocol related. So in our scripts, whatever we have been selecting, I mean, here in our load runner scripts, what are the protocols that we have been selecting? Which protocol that we have been selecting? Here in load here in view generator, while creating a script, which protocol that we have been selecting? I hope everyone remembers that. We have been selecting the web web protocol, or we can call it as like HTTP or HTML protocol. Okay, we have been using this protocol, right? So basically, this protocol is it will have some set of API calls. Those are nothing but web underscore URL, and if you remember web underscore. Reg underscore find. If you remember, this is the protocol. This is the API call that we have discussed as part of the verifications. I hope everyone has remembered this. Did you remember this this particular API call? Okay, web underscore reg underscore find. Okay, and here now whatever you see which start with web here. Let me open a recorded script here. Whatever protocol, whatever API call that you see with the web underscore, that will be called as a here. This web underscore add underscore cookie, this is a API call which is related to web protocol over here. Okay, this is a web protocol. And similarly, like this, if you whatever you see which start with web underscore something here, that will be called as a web protocol here. Can you all see this? Like whatever you see which start with web underscore, which will be called as a web underscore concurrent start web underscore URL. You can see most of the web underscore URLs over here. So here mainly for us, two protocols very important. Those are web underscore, reg underscore, find, which we'll be using as part of verifications. Okay, 1 minute. I'm saying that this is very important, and there is something called web underscore, reg underscore, save underscore, param. This is another protocol that API call as part of the verification we'll be using this. Basically, there is a concept called correlation. As part of correlation, we'll be using this one. Okay, so this is all about whatever we have been discussing, this is related to web application related. Okay, web or HTTP HTML protocol. Okay, which is related to HTTP HTML protocol. Okay, now here. I know if you talk about suppose SAP application, now SAP will have its own protocols here, SAP GUI, okay, it will have some kind of text box, enter text box, okay, it's been a long time, I think around 2.5 years, I guess, I worked on SAP performance testing, okay, SAP performance testing is very simple, I can say no, a bit complicated is web testing only, the other protocols are a bit easy, okay. I worked on SAP, Oracle and web protocol. I feel web is a bit complicated because there will be more of correlation. Whereas in SAP and Oracle, you will not find much of correlation. You can find, but it is very little, and straight away you can understand. Okay. So here, I'm trying to say that based on your application, this API calls may vary here. But however, it might be any protocol. It might be any protocol. These are the set of library. These are the set of API functions or API calls or some set of functions which we'll be using. these are the set of things which we can use across any protocol. But these are the protocols which are related to specific to a protocol. Now these are the things which are related to web protocol here. In this web protocol, this web underscore reg underscore find is the important as part of verification. This web underscore reg underscore save underscore param which will be important as part of correlation. We have to discuss this particular one. Okay, we have to discuss this one. And moreover, similarly here, say if you talk about SAP application, you will find SAP related protocols here. Okay, if you talk about the Oracle application, there is something like Oracle, I think it is OCA underscore. Okay, where you can find something like OCA underscore, you can find some set of API calls over here. Okay, so based on the type of the application, based on the type of the protocol, these API calls will vary here. Based on the type of application or protocol, these protocols varies. Okay, based on the type of application or protocol, okay. So here, now if we talk about these things, these are the protocol. These are the API functions. Are the normal function? I mean, I can say in general words, I can call it as a, these are the functions or API function API calls which we will be using across any type of protocol. Okay. I hope you are able to have an overall idea over here, what is happening here. So whenever you record a script here, basically the script has been representing based on your protocol, it is showing this. So this may contain a loadrunner related API calls, and it may contain application specific API calls. It will contain loadrunner related API calls and application related API calls over here. Now here among this load runner related API calls, I'm talking about the variables over here. Okay, here in a very high level I can see variables in load runner two types, C related, load runner related. Okay, here load runner related means here, for example, if you use web underscore reg underscore find here. Now see here, if you use web underscore reg underscore find, if you all remember, did you all remember about this particular functionality? Did you remember the parameters under this web underscore reg underscore reg underscore find? You know, I think it is there in here in action mode. Now everyone closely observe this highlighted line. If you remember, I said text is a parameter which will help us to what type of text you are basically looking in the request over here. I mean, in the response of this particular request. This is a request. In the response of this particular request, basically we were trying to find this particular text here. Okay. And here, if you remember, I said this is a variable here. This is a parameter over here. So save count equal to, it's a parameter over here. Okay. So basically it will find out the number of occurrences of this particular text here. Okay. Now this basically if it finds for 4 times, this daily deal CNT is going to becomes 4 here. This variable, this parameter will becomes 4. But however, this parameter, this highlighted is a parameter which is the load runner parameter. Okay. I cannot directly use this load runner parameter in a C loop. Say here if I want to know if this parameter value is greater than 4, sorry, greater than 0, then only I want to say this particular transaction is passed, right? If you all remember, did you all remember this one? Okay, here basically this is a parameter. This is a load runner parameter. Okay, you cannot directly use this load runner parameter in your C programming. Okay, I'm trying to explain this point. I've been trying to explain this particular point. Is the point clear? I'm saying that the highlighted one is a load runner parameter. We cannot directly use this load runner parameter in a C programming, okay? Because it is a load runner parameter. So now what we have to do? We have to convert this load runner parameter into a C variable over here. Okay. For that here, for that you have something called load runner evaluate string. LR underscore eval underscore string means basically it will convert a load runner variable into C variable over here. Okay, it will convert that value into C variable value over here. Okay, then here we have something like LR underscore save underscore string, which will help you to save a C variable into direct into a load runner variable. In the reverse case, say you have a C variable, you have a value in your C variable, directly you cannot use that C variable here in the programming. Okay, you cannot directly use the C variable here in the API calls of this. Okay, so that's what we actually today we are trying to understand here. Now let me create a script here. Let me open the C language 3 over here. Now see here what actually I'm trying to say here. If you remember, yesterday we were creating char, say for example S*1. Did you remember what is this? No, we understood it's an array of characters. In a general words, we can call it as a string. I hope everyone has remembered this one. Yesterday we were discussing about this. Okay, if you want to represent number of characters, if you want to mention a more than one character, you have to use this square braces. Now here, see, this is basically a C variable here. If you want to use this C variable, you cannot directly use in a load runner related programming here. You cannot use this C variable. This SSTR1, you cannot directly use in a load runner programming. So first of all, you need to convert this into a C C to load runner related variable. For that, you have something called LR underscore C here. I'm saying save underscore everyone observer string. Everyone observer, I'm saying basically converting the save variable to load runner variable. But more appropriate here will be parameter. Generally, we'll be calling it as a parameter. Okay, just to make you understand, I'm saying variable, but it's not exactly variable; it's a parameter. Okay, converting the C variable to load runner variable or load runner parameter here. So for that, I'm using LR underscore save string. Now, every observer here, I will be using this particular string. This is a C variable. Okay, now I'm converting into a load runner variable. Let me say LR var. Okay, now this is load runner variable. Let me say here, let me say C variable. Let me say let it be C var. Okay, this is a C variable. So here this is a load runner variable here. Okay. Now you didn't observe. Now this LR var is a load runner parameter. Now this hello, this value is being saved under this particular load runner value here. Now you didn't observe. Now let me convert. Now I'm saying that this is the load runner variable. Now again I'm trying to convert this load runner to C variable here. Now observe. I can say here LR underscore eval underscore. Now here, if you want to convert any load runner variable into if you want to see what is the value in that load runner variable, in other words, if you want to convert a load runner variable into a C variable, C value here, basically it's not exact one. Whatever I said, it's not exact one, but I'm trying to make you understand here. Okay, so here basically we are converting a C variable into a load runner parameter here, and here in this case I'm trying to find the what is the load runner parameter. What is the value that is being contained in the load runner parameter here? Okay, in other words, let me say converting LR variable to C value. Okay, or evaluating the load runner variable here. In other words, let me say LR evaluating the basically this highlighted line. Now basically this highlighted line will print print this particular value. It will evaluate and it will convert into a value here. Now here let me say here let me say char lr to c. See where lr var to, let me say lr var to c var. Okay, now I just created some empty variable here. Now see here, I'm capturing this variable into this value. Now this highlighter line basically it will evaluate what is the value that is contained in this variable, and it will assign into this variable. Now here we can print this. Now every observer, let me say lr underscore output. Message. Okay. Here let me say percentile is. Let me say initial C variable value. Okay. Now here initial C variable value is nothing but this one. Evaluated. Loadrunner to C variable value was this one. You know, it's a bit confusing probably, but don't really. It's not really. With just closely observe these things. Okay. Now here, let me keep a breakpoint here, or let us try to let me create a breakpoint here. And here, let us compile this. Let's see if it does have any errors. It is compiling. Now it seems there is an error over here. What is happening? Fine. Well, let me do one thing. Instead of this temporary variable, let me directly print over here. Here I'm directly printing this value. Okay. Now again let me try to see if there are any errors. Now here they're saying no errors detected. Now let me execute this. Now see here it is waiting at this particular line. Now let me use F10 in my keyboard. Now everyone up here, initial C variable value is hello here. Okay, initially the C variable value is hello here. Okay, now see here, let me go to the next one. What happened? Now can you agree here? Evaluated loadrunner to C variable value is also hello. It means basically what we have done, basically this is a C variable. We have saved this C variable into a loadrunner variable here. Okay, we are saving a C variable into a loadrunner variable here. And again we are converting, this is a loadrunner variable now. Now I want to see what this loadrunner variable is containing. So for that, here again I am saying this, loadrunner evaluate this so and so. So it has been printing this one. I hope everyone understood this. Basically this is a C variable. I'm saving whatever the value that is there in a C variable into a loadrunner variable here. Okay, it means whenever you want to save any C variable value into a loadrunner related value, you have to use this lr underscore save underscore string. Okay, basically here not exactly converting. It is basically we are saving a C variable into a loadrunner variable here. Because we cannot directly use this C variable in a programming. Here, see, this variable cannot be used in our this these functions like our LR underscore think time, or it is web underscore URL, web underscore reg underscore find. We cannot use these variables directly. Okay, so if you want to make use of these C variables directly here in the loader now, basically you have to convert. You have to save the value of this C variable into a load runner variable here. In a similar way, if you want to make use of a load runner parameter directly in the C programming, we cannot. We have to use something like LR underscore LR underscore string over here. Okay, these are not exactly converting. I can say these are like basically we are saving a C variable value into a load runner variable value. And here load runner variable value, we are trying to find the what is the value that is there in the load runner variable over here. For that we are using something called LR underscore save underscore sync, LR underscore eval underscore sync. So whenever you want to interact with C related programming, you have to use this LR underscore save underscore sync. You have to use LR underscore eval underscore sync. Okay, I hope everyone understood this. You cannot directly use C related information here in loadrunner. If you want to interact C program with the loadrunner related things, you have to use LR underscore save underscore string and LR underscore eval underscore string. These two are mandatory. So it's in a very simple case here basically. So here simply I'm saving a the value in a C variable into a load runner variable over here. And here the value in a load runner variable we are trying to print here. Okay, that's it. Here we have something like average the value of a load runner parameter. Average the value of load runner parameter. Here saves the C variable value. Loadrunner parameter. Okay, and the syntax here will be LR underscore eval underscore string of here you should use a double quotation and you should use this floor braces and the parameter name here. And here I know it can be anything which is related to load runner information. Okay, it can be this web underscore reg underscore find, or it can be anything which is related to load runner. Okay, I hope you are getting what I'm saying. It is not only web underscore reg underscore find, it can be anything which is related to load runner. Okay, even here in web underscore reg underscore save param also we'll be having some parameter will be there. Okay. So even in that case also probably will be LR eval string or eval save string. Okay, parameter name, raw basis, double quotation, this is the spelling. Okay, LR eval string, this is the syntax. Whereas this one saves the variable into a load runner parameter. It will have like LR underscore save underscore string underscore string. And here the C variable. Within double quotation, we will be mentioning LR parameter. Okay, and these two are very important. Okay, you have to say that it evaluates the value of load on the parameter and it saves the C variable into a load on the parameter over here. In other words, in just to remember this, what you can do here, you can say that loadrunner2, you can just to remember, you can say loadrunner2C. I used to remember like this because these two are a bit confusing. So I used to remember like this. Okay, this is C2 loadrunner. Now apart from this, now I think we understood these things. We also understood this output message. Yep. We'll be discussing LR underscore endos point a bit later. Now we'll be discussing these two. LR underscore advanced underscore param, LR underscore next underscore row. Basically these two are again related to parameterization. Okay. These two are the loadrunner related API functions. But however, these two will help us in parameterization. Say here, let me write it here itself. These might be rare cases, but however, we'll try to understand what is this LR underscore advanced underscore param here. Now, let me save this. Sir, we have been trying to understand in action, right? Let me go to the user unit. And how to create a parameter file? How to create a parameter? How we can insert the values into parameterization? Here I want to keep a data here. I want to keep some data here in this particular parameter file over here. How can we achieve that? I hope everyone has been remembering this. Now please everyone practice this. Okay. Fine. If you all remember, go to design menu, parameters, parameter list. I hope I have mentioned it in the syllabus here. Okay, probably if you refer the recording video, you will get it. However, here you know we use in design menu. Parameters. Design parameters list. Okay, parameters list. Okay, so this is how we can create a parameters. So now here, I hope everyone of you remember these things. Okay, now here let me create some username. Okay. Now see here, let me create a table here, and see here, let me select by name. Everyone has remembered this particular thing, right? Say yes or no. I hope everyone has remembered this. And see here, I'm creating a password. And if you remember, I said it is preferable to have a single DAG file instead of multiple DAG files. If you remember, you know, for each thing, it has been basically creating multiple DAG files. So here for password also we'll try to use the same username DAG file. Okay. Now we see here I'm selecting here. First of all, for each parameter we should have each column over here. So let me say add column. Let me say password. Now select by name. Select password over here. Okay. And if you want to rename, say if you want to see the difference.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.